Well, hello and welcome to what amounts to football heaven. It doesn't get a whole lot better than this. The conditions are utopian. The sky is blue and the players are with us for a football match so widely and keenly anticipated. Truly, this is pristine. And the level of expectation and excitement is reflected in the smiling faces of the crowd. They know it means so much, and they also experience between them a great sense of privilege. In with a header! Danger averted for now. Oh, he's felt, he's had a shot! From immediate danger. Oh, sweet feet. Good take, and he's had a look. Tries to get it forward quickly. Chance to break.
Just to point out, Peter, that the fullbacks are quite high.
And what do they try to achieve?
Well, it's obviously a move to push the opposition wide men back and give them more to think about.
And there's a long ball. Cleared away. Now can he finish? Chooses to go back. Has a goal! It's there!
Oh, what a cracking goal, but a cracking touch as well. That's what made it for me. That's brilliant play all round.
Woking draw first blood here.
Still a fragile lead though, they can't afford to sit on this.
Battles to win it back. Now the counter. He's making good use of his strength there, just refuses to be out-muscled. He could have been in, just needed a better final ball.
Ah, quality deserted them when they really needed it.
Back into the middle. Goes for goal! Oh, that was no routine save.
Well, that was high-class goalkeeping there to back up his high-class weight.
Ferdinand. He's found his man. And he's cut it out. Whistle for half time. So there you have it, a close fought half of football. But it still had its moments, but ultimately produced just one goal. A decent game up to now.
Well, they showed glimpses of some wonderful football to groom with the lead at half time, and that's definitely pleased the fans. I think they'll be looking to keep this intensity up now in the second half.
Woking will have the lead in a tight old game. Half time, 1-0. And we're off again.
A solitary goal. That has been the crucial difference.
He'll hit it. This could fall anywhere.
Well, that's confidence for you. Distance doesn't even bother him.
And that's a throw.
Well, there's no sign here of forwards working back. They are staying upfield.
They are, Peter, and it gives them a chance to break, but it's also causing an extra defensive presence to prevent that.
Oh, shooting chance! Oh, that was nice, but not quite the end product required.
That was created because of good, lively movement, which pretty much dictated the pass.
Hoists it forward.
Your impression so far, Jim?
Well, while the temptation's always there, Peter, I think it would be ill-advised of them to try settle for what they've got.
And he's going long.
Too much on it, and that's the keeper's.
And it's played forward.
Goes long.
And that's been levered clear.
Ah, now some movement on the bench, and we are going to see a change.
Lofted into the middle.
Well, it's good stuff. This is better.
Hitting hope is just about the sum of it, isn't it, Jim?
Spot on, Peter.
It has got through to him.
Plays it out to the flank.
He's gone for it! Oh, it's opened up nicely for him.
Keep calm and carry on. That's the job in a nutshell now.
Oh, he's broken through.
Has a hit! Oh, it's a stunning goal! Oh, it really is a finish of the highest order. A two-goal cushion, and it's looking safe.
Oh, Peter, it's a lovely piece of deception in shaping to whack it and then opting for a lovely little lob.
So, time for changes on both sides, actually.
Two up and very little time left. Surely this is it.
Well, some fans are already on their way out, so that to me says everything, Peter.
And that is it. The referee has seen enough. Woking always looked the more driven side, probably the better side, and nobody is arguing about the results. So what do you take away from it all, Jim?
What I most admire about this outfit is the cohesion and the willingness to work hard as a unit and getting behind the ball. Do the ugly stuff. That's what gets you clean sheets and wins.
So we've reached the end of our coverage for today. Many thanks to Jim Beglin alongside me, and we'll both